see if you can put your elbows on the floor, lift your head and shoulders, and go slow speed. Yes, like that. And you can bend your knees a little bit and come a little bit further away from the wall if you like. And just rock on your back, rock on your spine. So take the block up. Come a little bit away from the wall. A little bit away from the wall and rock. Rock on your back. Make your back U shape and just rock on your back. Keep your head lifted. Now stomach tight, stomach tight. Okay, watch ball. Watch ball, please. Stomach is really tight, stiff, firm, strong. Head up, head in the air, head in the air, don't put the head on the floor. Okay, then keep coming a little bit further away from the wall. Put your elbows on the floor and see how high can you lift your upper body. Yeah, so lift your upper body. No, upper body. Lift it. Yeah, yeah. Now put palms on the floor and try and keep lifting. So come away from the wall. Yeah, you are too close. This is, we are trying vertical western. Okay, don't go too far in it. Put your palms on the floor and lift up. Vertical western. Paschimottanasana. Vertical Paschimottanasana. Palms on the floor, elbows on the floor. Push and lift. Lift your upper body. Lift your head. Hug your legs. Yeah, go ahead. Bow, palms. Lift elbows. Elbows off. Elbows off. Elbows up. Use your arm strength. Palm on the floor. Yeah, there you go. Go forward. Go forward. See what happens in the stomach. Firm up. Straight, straight, straight. Palm on the floor. Palm on the floor. You can't lift. Okay, let's see. Okay, fold the legs. You want to take your palms off the floor and fold the legs. Yeah, so you need to come a little bit further away from the wall, right? Yeah, yeah, that's a little bit more.
I know, don't let go of you, don't let go of me.
Anyway, that's good. Firm up, firm up, firm up, firm up. Heels to ceiling. Push heels up, toes in. That's good. Hug, 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 tight, tight, tight. Eliminate the gap between thigh and stomach. There you go.
Stop that.
Your palms on the floor, people. Palms on the floor. Lift your arms. Lift up your arms. Lay down, close your legs, take a couple breaths. Yes,
so I wait.
So I wake up. Before I get up, I do this. Before I get up, I do this. Okay, right. Good form. Lower back recovery, restorating is really important. I can't emphasize enough. Of how we abuse our lower backs and how it would help if you recover your lower back, not just for yoga, but even for daily routine activities. But today we're going to focus on forward bend. We'll do some warriors. Warriors are really, really powerful. I've said this multiple times, I used to skip warriors. You know, there's nothing stretching or powerful in warriors, right? And now I feel that you show me a pose, and if you tell me that it does not give you stretch, I'll show you the stretch. So specifically warriors, really, really powerful. When you align the body, when you use some of this firming up thing that we talked about here, you'll be amazed how much strength warriors require and how powerful it is. It gives tremendous hamstring stretch. It has huge range of motion, which none of the other poses do, right? Sitting poses, supine poses are very, the more skin that touches the floor, the less freedom of movement you have. But when you are on your feet, you have tremendous range of motion. The more range of motion, the more you can circulate blood and air and whatnot and stretch, right? And the joints. So we're gonna do some warriors, we'll go into the forward bend, we'll combine some weights into that, and then we'll do some pranayama, some breathing. So forward bend, as I mentioned yesterday, if you want to do pranayama, forward bend is the key. And you will see why. Forward bend all the time slows down, calms down the breathing. That's kind of a good segue into exercising in breath. Okay, let's do some of the things that we did yesterday, the stomach press. If you don't take anything from these 2 days of classes, please just take this thing back with you every morning, you know, just give your stomach a little bit of squeeze. So bend your knees, sit a little bit. So you don't want this. This is arch. You want this. And you can do that with your knees bent, right? If your legs are straight, it's a little bit harder to round the spine. But with knees bent, as if you're sitting on the high stool, exhale, chin to chest, fingers in front of the navel, close to the navel, thumbs on the side, exhale and push in. Push with the fingers, pull with the stomach, both. Then release and then inhale. So, let me show you. Don't push the fingertips in, that will make it uncomfortable. You want the whole area. You want this whole thing massage. Not just this. This kind of would make you feel uncomfortable because it's poke.
Yes.
So bring it in more to the front. So all you want is some grip on the side. The organs are mainly here. That you want. Exhale, pull. And press. Pull in with the stomach, press with the fingers. Bring fingers in the front. Yeah, fingers in the front. More. Yeah. Chin to chest. Say if you have. If you want to try, keep the head up and then try and do the same thing and see how it feels uncomfortable. And then you want to really lower your chin. The lower back. Again, not fingertips, but the whole fingers, whole palm goes in. See, we haven't moved. How tired am I? Once I show it to the doctor, you know, the abdomen churning, there was some background to that. Wow, I've never seen anybody do that. That must require tremendous core strength. So the movement is here, but it's coming from here. And strength in the lower back. Let's do a little bit of joint warming up, loosening up. Remember the fabulous 5 points. And then we'll come back to the stomach press in palm-milking pose. Two knees, so unless you have knee issues, then I'll show you alternate way. Both knees, both elbows. And then head. On the floor, then river. Head, elbows, and the knees. Both knees together. Slower, the better. Slower, the harder. We are little too hard. No need to rush. Yeah, that's good. And then lift your head, elbows, and both knees. Tilt back. No. Just tilt back. So from here, you're going to slow, right? So tilt back. See that pose. Tilt back. Yeah. Feet apart. Okay. So we had this challenge thing in our indie group, and there were people who reached up to 45 points a day. I tried to do about 70 per day. I split between 30-35 in the morning, 30-35 in the evening. So, I mean, as you talked yesterday, you know, it's all theory unless you experience it. One of the theory that's in the books is that if you do this, it will keep diseases at bay. You will be very healthy. Your joints will be very heavy. 5 points is a powerful, powerful exercise. As simple as it looks, and see, most of us are able to do that here, so it's a little bit of that. But see, we don't do this in our daily life. Let's see if you can combine this with a little bit of our bandha and some press on. So, forward bends, you exhale. Remember, you can't have a balloon in the stomach and then go forward. So, opposite back bend is inhale. So, let's say we inhale, we exhale. Then release, then inhaling. Come. Make sense? Exhaling, go down. Inhaling, come up. That's right, you can bring one foot forward, you know, in 2 weeks, your whole thing will be going up. Stay focused on the stomach today. Focus on the lower back. bends are stretches, forward bends are strength poses. Right? So when you do the back bends, the front stretches. When you do the forward bends, the back lifts. So it requires tremendous strength. What do people think? How many you think you can do tomorrow morning? 10?
5.
5 is good, yeah, that's one. Start with 5, and by end of the week, you will keep adding the ball every day of the alternate day. By the end of the week, you'll be 10. Trust me. 2 weeks. 2 weeks is my solution to every problem, right? With the regularity. You need regularity. Do it in the morning, do it in the evening. Excellent day, way to warm up in the morning and wind down in the evening. And then go to bed. Do 10 or 12 of these. Do a little bit more of stomach press, the bandhas. So remember three bandhas, chin to chest, pulling abdominal organs up, navel in and up. Next, stomach in and up. So chin to chest, garandharvan, regulates blood, regulates thoughts, slow down breathing. Then exhale, navel in and pull up, abdominal organs up. Use your imagination, it doesn't matter if it's happening or not. Set the stomach under the ribcage, inside the ribcage. Feel the lower ribs, floating ribs poking out of the skin. Feel the lower back rounding, feeling good, happy. Then release the stomach and then inhale. Remember, Uddiyan Bandha, stomach in and up only after exhalation. Two before inhalation, only in between that phase. Okay, then take the block. Let's sit in the column of people's. Remember, you need the block.
Yeah, I got a question.
Yeah.
I'm getting confused by the inhalation, exhalation, then the bandhas, because when I'm exhaling, I'm pulling my stomach in anyway, right? So,
yeah.
So I'm bringing, I'm exhaling. And then I pull the bandha, but I've already feel like I've already started the exhale. You know, I've already started the bandha when I exhale.
So you're already engaging, but there is a lot more movement that can happen after you completely exhale. So in the process of exhalation, you can't go all the way in. So I exhale.
So you start the motion with the exhale.
Right, so you can complete like that, then it becomes lighter. So you know, at least your first part is right. Most people say that when you inhale, sound goes in.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And the way we breathe, if you tighten the stomach, then therefore you will do. You inhale, you will actually pull the sound in. And so when you inhale, sound should come out.
Right.
Because you will feel air, and exhale, sound should go in. So that part is right. But after that has happened, there is a lot more that you can pull in. Right? So. So after that sound soft, that's what I accept. Okay, the soft sound, I soft exhalation.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have to pull some of it. So, see, keep it
so then you relax your bandha and then you inhale. Is that right?
I'm actually, my Uddiyan is not even engaged when I'm doing it. So yeah, it's something firm, but I don't think that is actually bandha. You know what I mean? So the Uddiyan bandha happens once I start pulling some in after exhalation.
Right.
So during exhalation, I don't have a Uddiyan Bandha. I don't have Mula Bandha, right? And so if I'm sitting, I can have. So now I have Mula Bandha, right? You know, I'm pulling the organs up already, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I can hold. Inhale, exhale, I can continue to pull abdominal organs, perineum upward, right? This is what is really tight. This skin is going up, this is going in. But then when I want to do Uddiyan, this is Dandha. So I exhale. So see, some of this is allowed. I mean, it doesn't have to be. And I'm using all these anchors to get strength here in this area. Right? So I'm pushing this. If I were to keep this, so the Uddiyan Bandha doesn't really begin until I've completely exhaled. The Mula Bandha is there. Maybe you're feeling the firmness of the middle body. So this is sperm bank. This is not really my
fine.
Yeah, my life is amazing.
And then you add to that the bandha.
Yeah.
And then when you go to inhale, you relax the Uddiyana bandha first?
You must release. You
okay.
Must release the bandha.
Okay.
See that how my throat restricted. If I try to breathe with Uddiyana, it's like the vacuum suck, you know. It just really.
It almost feels the opposite for me. So when I relax that Uddiyana bandha, I feel a tremendous vacuum in my throat.
Yeah.
And then when I inhale, I really it just like
pushes
Yeah.
So maybe slow release and then a pause after. So don't hold till you drop. Don't hold it last. Drop energy is used.
Yeah.
You know, so release. So I release, and I'm still holding my breath. So I had time to recover from that. It is tremendous strength that you're applying, right? So as soon as you say, okay, all the blue, then the water is.
Yeah.
I do the same in this, and then we'll see if more strength. So whenever you get tired, you can put the block under the knees. Try and start without the blocks if you can. So we did two things. I like the pull, but it's a little bit harder. So remember, forces in opposite direction gives you stability. Forces in the same direction gives you movement. We don't want movement. We want stability. We want anchoring, strong foundation. So it happens when you push arms down and knees up, like this. This force, you see how I lift it up a little bit? You know, this half an inch of height makes a huge difference. This, firm and strong, right? It becomes one, that's yoga, combining. Toes, with ankles, with knees, with thighs, with lower back, with shoulders, with arms, with wrists, back to knees. Right? It's whole body one. Okay, so this is down and up, and then you can do it. And then all another one was pulling knees up with your palms and pushing knees down to the knees. Right? That's again forces in opposite direction. So you see how this part runs. The harder I pull the knee up with my palms, the more strength I feel in the stomach, navel to spine. So I'm generating strength with the limbs and using it in the core. You generate strength here. So if you put some kind of weighing or pressure sensing machine here, you will see how much pressure, how much weight, how much force I'm applying on my knees. In front of the lower back. Okay, when you get tired, put the block under the knees and then you should be the same thing. So focus is on chin to chest, navel in, and pulling stomach, abdominal organs up. Please don't worry whether you're feeling, whether it's happening or not, just imagine. Just keep concentrating, think, focus, talk to those muscles. Talk to this area in the stomach and then see what starts happening with you. So try both, pushing down and up. Pulling up and down, right? Up and down. Yeah, that's good. Well, the back is kind of starting to run. Take the arch out, don't keep the arch out. Yeah.
No, I think the forward is fine, and then maybe come back a little bit and go. Okay, so now you bring legs here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, now hold and pull. Yeah. You see this movement? This cannot happen in during exhalation process. This that you went in, okay, so now release. And then, yeah. Okay. Let's see how much can you pull in when you exhale. Yeah, more now pull in. There. You see that movement that happened after you completed your exhalation. Whichever pose you're comfortable with. I like to sit in the sitting warrior with feet to the side. But if you want to sit in the regular warrior, even in the simple cross-legged, white cross-legged, might be able. Yeah, that one gives a little bit more anchoring and strength. And sit on the block. So take a block or two, and if you want to sit on the block, that's good too. So there's this one. Kriya or I don't know what this we call it. It's not like the pose, but round it. massages the organs.
Agnisa?
Right. But I mean, I was trying to, I think it's a Kriya. So you exhale, and then you first put the fists in, and you gently massage the organs, right? And then Sahira. So obviously, you need to keep the air out and don't hold too long, right? Don't stay too long. Just do once or twice and come back up and see how you feel. You don't want to, you know, go to the last drop of oxygen used. So, two chest, exhale. So, in child pose, with my stomach in, and I'm massaging this organ. And nice and gentle. Okay? The idea is these muscles don't move. When you put food inside, it becomes further stiff. Right? We don't do much with these muscles. Right? The core strength isn't there. So, what we are trying to do is just loosening this muscle. So, inhale, exhale, pull stomach in, push fists in the stomach, bow forward, and then just move the fists in circular motion. Nice and gentle.
Yeah, bow, 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 come on, go down. Slow. Yeah. Even if you don't move, you just nothing forward. Balasana, child pose. Yeah. So just the fist itself, the bowing in child pose, just that itself will give you good So even if you don't move and just stay there for 3, 4, 5 seconds, you'll feel about, you know, the bandhas and when to begin, when to end, or what muscles to engage, what muscles to release before you inhale, things like that. If you try to keep the fists pushed in, either bowing or without bowing, right? And then if you try to inhale, you'll be amazed what happens, what kind of uncomfortable feeling gets into people who have these tight muscles. They feel like it all the time because they're not getting deeper. They just never feel that they have enough air, and there's physical therapy and all kinds of things that they do. But it's really powerful that this area, the muscles in this area are loosened, that the diaphragm can move down and up off of the screen. Right? Otherwise, you have effect all the way, not just physically, but even mentally. So try that. Exhale, inhale. Exhale. Press. Now continue to press and then try and inhale. And see how little air. I mean, you literally feel that, wow, my lungs only half full. You feel that? Mm-hmm. And then if you were to bow further and try to breathe, you can do that. Okay, let's become warriors. And then we'll come to the more forward bending weights. So generally, wall is a good idea. So here, I think we'll work with the clues. Just pay attention to the shoulder and hip part, as I mentioned. Alignment is really important. If you are not focused on alignment, warriors will be boring. Warriors will not give you any stretch. So alignment is really, really the key. Two keywords to remember in every pose. Remember, Iyengar's extend. It comes from the back, right? It comes from the back, middle back, shoulders, arms. Close your ears with your shoulders. How high can you lift your shoulders? Can you close your ears with your shoulders? Can you close your ears with your shoulders? Squeeze. There you go. Okay, so let's extend. And expand. Broad, wide. Right in the center, going in opposite direction. Equal force, left and right. Okay, so maintain this width, maintain this extension. Rotate left leg from hip joint. Spread the toes apart. So this is what I mean. Spread the fingers apart. It's like you stretch the fingers of the palm. You can spread the toes of the foot. Yeah, that 1 inch of surface area will make a huge difference. And rotate left. The key, your upper shoulder and upper hip
should be pushed back. If you were against the wall, upper hip and upper shoulder would be on the wall, right? And then right arm can go up. If you want more stretch, remember the side stretch? How do you get more stretch? You put your shoulder on your ear. You want further more stretch, you put your palm on the opposite shoulder. Right palm, left shoulder. This way, upper shoulder, upper hip back. Upper shoulder, upper hip back. Okay, then you bend the knee, bend left knee, keep holding the ankle, left ankle with left hand, push the left knee with your elbow. Left knee back with your elbow, upper shoulder, upper hip back. Look to the sky. Look to the sky. Okay, here's another clue. So your upper arm, see if you can bring it around and hold the left thigh. Hold the left thigh. Yeah, sit, may not sit. Yeah, 90 degrees, spread feet apart. There. So you see, yeah, the shoulder, exactly. The more you keep bringing. Yeah, exactly. So the more you do this, the more the shoulder will come back. Right? And this should be strong anchor, right? You don't want the knee to push forward. Kumasana, lower your knee, knee to elbow. That's good, that's good. Take the shoulder back. Okay, and twist. So the opposite. So right elbow, left knee. No, right shoulder, left knee. See if you can balance. Maybe put one finger on the floor if you like. Ankle. Opposite to right shoulder, right palm. Again, you can reach for your left thigh with your left hand. Go around it. That's good, Mila. That's good. Yeah. So, okay, so lift the heel. Lift the left heel. Straighten both legs, both hands on either side of the foot, and lay low. Knee slightly flex, just a little bit flexion. Hug your leg. Feel the hamstring stretch. Can you feel the left hip going away from the left heel? As you feel comfortable, straighten the leg. Okay, those of you who are able to, see if you can wrap your arms around the legs. Yep. Cross them around. Right comes from the left comes from the right. Hold. If you're able to balance. Hug tight. Hold tight. Legs are the foundations. The stronger the foundation, the more stable the building. Okay, we'll transition to warrior one. So arms behind, interlock fingers. Lift. How high can you lift your arms? To the ceiling and up. The straighter the arms, the firmer the back. Okay, and start arching your back. So this was rounding, right? When your chin was to your knee, you were rounding. Now, arch. Lift your head up and arch. Arch. Look out. Lift. Rise. 2 feet should feel like rocks. Strong, solid. Okay, so the chest pushed up, shoulders behind chest. Really important thing to remember in forward bends. Maintain this firmness of the back, of the chest, arms up, close your ears. And extend. Lift. Pull yourself with yourself. Maintain this upward lift, close ears, and bend front knee. The whole attention goes in the back leg. Back leg really straight. So I give you a very time adi, otherwise I would have a very time adi staying on the back legs, each of you. Back leg really straight. Back leg really straight. All the way to the back leg.
That was me.
Yeah. I should have that. When friendly warrior one. Warrior one is really important. Very, very powerful pose. Arms straight. Don't bend too much. Close your ears. More. Close your ears. And then look to the sky. Look to the palms. There you go. That's good. Okay. Now, let's lean forward. So we can come a little bit back. Those of you who are near the wall, come leg length. Open the wall and lean forward. The more you lean forward, the lighter the back legs feels. Right? So keep your chest on the front knee and see if you can lift your back leg. Arms pull forward and then rise. Yeah, lift the leg. The goal is not to keep the arms out, but the leg out. Back leg. It's okay to keep arms long. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Heart is full of fingertips, broaden in the shoulders. Arms in back. Yeah, there you go. That's good. You can keep arms covering. Legs should be stronger. Legs should be straight. That's good. Sarvita, very good. Now see if you can spread the hips to the side. Keep leg this way. Focus on the leg. Yeah, only as much as it allows. Strong, firm. That's good. Yeah, go ahead. Arms in the front. You have the support in the back. There. Strong legs. Your whole attention should be on the leg that is lifting the weight. Okay, for the next one, you will need the wall. So when you're against the wall, you just transition smoothly. But here, you're doing this, right? Warrior 3. Keep the right hand on the wall. Left hand, next to the left foot, and rotate. You see the difference, the range of movement that is possible? This, Warrior 3. This, Ardha Chandrasana. And then we'll go to the vertical version, right? So just put palms on the wall and forward next to you. And then rotate. Focus on the hip joint, the left hip joint. You want to push it out forward as much as possible. Yep, so jump in the right hand on the pole. Upper hip, upper shoulder back. Remember, very simple rule of thumb in warrior. Upper hip, upper shoulder back. And trust me, to this day, I've not been able to do enough of that. So can you imagine, can you visualize how would it feel if you were against the wall? Upper hip, upper shoulder back. So look. If I was doing the warrior Ardha Chandrasana, okay, I'll say, oh wow, you know, my hand is on the floor and I don't get any stretch. What has happened to my shoulder and my hip? They're not on the wall. And see what happens. Look what happens, what needs to happen when I try to get the... See, I can't reach the floor. There, upper hip, upper shoulder on the wall. Now, tremendous stretch here, right? So the goal is not to touch the floor, right? Now, there is nothing that can take my attention away from my leg joint. It's tremendous stretch here. Okay. So that's what wall does. Wall gives you feedback. It gives you alignment, whether you're aligned, whether you're straight or not. For back bend, forward bend, wall is really powerful. Yeah, exactly. Right? You see that? I've done this for years, and I do it in the middle of the room, and I say, yeah, I got full stretch. And then if I go next to the wall, so all you need in your home is 6 foot of wall. That's your best teacher ever. Yeah, stick, and put the palm on the wall. Okay, and this is everybody's favorite pose, next pose. So you go to down dog, think towards the wall. So we are doing anything on the left leg, remember? So every left leg stays on the floor. So feet. Left foot on the floor, right up, and your goal is what? Both legs on the wall, stomach on thigh. One day, right? So bring the foot a little bit away from the wall, and keep going. Put weight on your arms.
That's good. Straighten one leg at a time, lower leg. That's good. No, both legs up on the wall. One leg down, one leg up, vertical split. Yeah, and switch. Straighten upper leg, then bend upper knee, and then straighten lower leg. Yeah, that's it. Focus on the stretch. Urdhva Prasarita Ek Padok Tamasana. Right? Vertical split. Try the whole series on the other side.
That pillar is not very strong.
I'm not trying to put too much force in it.
I don't know what it is.
Keep
moving.
Oh, I'm sorry.
John, come here. Hey, other side. Warriors, yeah. The story we used to read in history books that these soldiers and warriors, they wouldn't have time to sit any, so they would, on their horses, they would pluck, you know, whatever produce was ready in the farm, the fields, and they were right, yeah, and pea card, and whatever.
It's like a drive through. It's like
the yeah. Yeah, no time to stop it, sorry. Alright, extend. And what is the next word? Please help me out.
Expire.
And spread the toes. Surface area is really, really important. This is maybe 1 inch extra versus toes together. Big difference. Right? Okay, so what happens to the upper hip, upper shoulder? Rotate the toe.
Yeah.
There. Opening the pelvis is key for warriors, right? Yeah, there. Upper hip, upper shoulder. Push it back. And then arm can point to the ceiling, above your ear, or on the shoulder. There. Rotate. Side stretch. Take it from up, not from down. Arm from up. Yeah, make a cushion and push back with your head. Let's see what happens to the shoulder. Yeah, reach for the shoulder first and then reach for the shoulder. Okay. And then push there. Okay, and bend the knee. Yeah, anchor. You don't have to go too low. Stretch slowly around your spine, bend your knee a little bit. See the gentle stretch. Then arms, wrap your palms, arms around the leg, hug it tight. See if you can balance the 2 feet.
Yeah. Slowly, yeah. Keep it slightly bent.
Okay, so that's the recovery. Then arms on your back, interlock fingers. Start arching your back, lift arms up, arch, shoulders behind chest. This is precursor for warrior one. Lift, rise. Okay, maintain the firmness of the back and arms up. Close your ears, warrior one. Bend front knee. All the attention on your back leg. Back leg, really straight. Do whatever you can, every drop of energy that you have. Used to keep back knee straight. Nothing else matters until the back knee is straight, right? Your arms, your straighten the spine. None of that is important if your back is not straight. If your back leg is not straight. And lower, rest your chest on your knee, on your thigh. Again, focus more on the leg. Lean forward until the back leg can take off. Lift back leg up first and then rise. Whatever you like. And keep your palms close to you, open the elbows, spread the wings, be comfortable. Leg on the floor is very solid. Okay, then Ardha Chandrasana, right
right hand on the floor, sideways. Feel the stretch.
So maybe don't put the, see if you can just balance with the hand in the leg. Give more. So if you try to go too low, then maybe it's getting long. So yeah, there's more movement possible if you can open it. So just okay, so don't lean too much. Yes, that's the
against the wall, it would be much easier. And working also there. So this side, right leg will stay on the floor, left leg up on the wall. Right, and go down. Alternate, straightens upper leg, upper knee, then straightens lower knee. The goal is to get stomach to thighs. You know, forward bend. It's good. No. Stomach to thighs. Stomach to thighs. Yeah. Okay. Now switch. Yeah. And bend this knee. Straighten this leg and get strong. So bend the neck like this. Yeah. See, you straighten this knee. That's good. Release the weight on the hands. Release the weight on the hands. Okay, take the toe out. If you straighten the toe, maybe you should be. On the walls, and then we can recover on the wall. So if you're against the wall, bend the knees, left leg, and left my arm, right, left, left, right. And then you can jump where you go to the same knees. Take to the wall, come on a couple of feet, not far away from the wall. You need to sit on the wall. Yeah. Put all your weight here like that. Put all your weight on the wall. Pull this way, so this will lift up, and eventually the knee goes forward. So you're starting here, and then if I keep doing this, if I keep pulling this, my heart muscles tighter and tighter, stomach and tight. So hamstring tightness is also related to, or is because of, lower back weakness, right? Lower back not being strong. So they both kind of go hand in hand. When the lower back becomes strong, you will feel that my hamstrings are not as tight. So those of you from me, remember the punishment. Okay, so come off the wall, keep knees bent, arms around legs. See if you can touch your earlobes. Touch your earlobes a little bit.
Touch my ears with what?
Touch your ears with your palms, with your fingers. Ear.
Oh my god, my cheeks is
Yeah, that's it.
So this was the punishment if you didn't do homework. So I'm sure all of you memorized the language that you need to do. What you need to do. But there's something about this, I think you are doing some lines, there's something about this making more blood circulation in the brain,
yeah,
or
the,
somehow.
The cross,
right,
and
yeah,
then
yeah,
the punishment.
And it does, right? It does increase the blood circulation in the brain when you do this. And there is some connection between ears and mind being more disciplined. Let's see, Mila, how would you feel in terms of the opposite? See? So this is arms from outside in. Can you bring arms from inside out? So we did the garland pose yesterday, right? Put the belt on your back. Yeah, right here. Come forward a little, come forward. Arms from inside. Yeah, yeah. Bow. Shoulders behind knees. Shoulders behind knees. Or next to the knees.
You are more flexible than you think you are.
Yes,
put the belt on your back and then flat it.
Yeah, so now take the arms, rotate your arms. Yes, so you can balance yourself. Allow the movement to go through, right? So
even
it's
actually bringing your shoulder behind your knee.
Shoulder behind the knee, right.
And that can't do much anymore.
Yeah, still feel like it's a good moment. Okay, let's do some weights. So you can try a couple different ones and whichever one you're comfortable with. So you can go into the Prasarita Padottarasana. This is one of my favorite forward bend actually. And we'll try to do this couple of exercises just to walk. So we'll do Prasarita Padottanasana and then we'll Prasarita Padottanasana. Alignment is important, right? If you don't do alignment, you say, oh, it's too easy. It's not enough strength. Make your heels touch the wall. Heels touch the wall and it's very simple. You want to fold from the hips, right? Heels touching the wall. So arms in the front is harder. Go arms on the side and then go down as much as you can. That's fine. You can put palms on the floor, right? Let's see.
Very simple, right? Very simple alignment exercise. Yeah, what happened?
He's touching the wall.
That's all you want to remember, right? Maybe that's all you want to try. And what happened? It's alignment, right? You want to down the wall and say, nah, it's too easy. It's too easy.
Is the wall pushing you forward or what?
Wall
making you fall?
Yeah.
See?
You can show this trick to your friend at the surface and say, okay, let's see who can do this. All you have to do is leg straight, heels touching the wall, hold.
It's
true, but you need portable walls too.
Yeah, you can use
my one. No, the surface now.
So that is a back stretch. Okay, so move your feet 6 inches, 4 inches away from the wall.
Right, it's the back that lifts.
Okay, then if you can, hold your ankles and pull. Hold your ankles and pull yourself in. Pull yourself through. It's tremendous blood rushing into your head.
Feel the head rush. Split, we love split a little bit more. Why are you going to lean forward? Why are you going to lean?
Yeah, pull. Your head should be clean. Yes, there. That's strong. Mighty. Excellent. The bell and vajra, 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 split, split. The more you split, the lower the head comes. Bob, if you can, put weight on the toes. You should not be able to lift your toes. If you can lift your big toes off the floor, you're not putting enough weight forward. Posing is not correct. Your big toes should be nailed, hammered, anchored into the mat, into the floor. That's good, Sarita. That's good. And that's why you're holding your ankles. Okay, keep chin to chest when you come up. Jalandhar Bandh, it slows down the
breathing.
And regulates the blood flow. So because if you are sitting or laying down, or if you do something in this inverted pose and then suddenly stand up, you may feel dizzy. So if you want to try a couple of these, and whichever one works for you, you can go into Prasarita Padottanasana against the wall. Right? Put your head on the floor. And then go into headstand. Or those of you who did the crane yesterday, try the crane. Crane on the floor. The wall is there, try not to use it.
Right. You can use these for the head cushion.
If you haven't tried either, then try split. Prasarita Padottanasana first. Push your arms down. With all your might. The goal is not to take off today, right?
Yeah.
Think of right brother, right brother point.
Yeah.
So your palms need to be in front of the head. So make a triangle. So if my head is here, my palms are going to be here, like this. So not in the same line. That's not support, that's not balance. This is tripod is balance.
Yeah, so now head, yeah. And your knee a little bit. Yes, flex knees, yeah. And then go ahead towards the wall a little bit. Hit on the toes. Feel, yeah, strong, right knee.
Oh, no. That's scary.
Yeah, try the elbow on the floor around so you can see that.
Start there. Take a couple of breaths and then firm up the stomach. Really tighten it up and then the lower back.
So you can start there. Start with your head on the floor. Get some more strength now.
Yeah, put your head on the floor. Stomach in. Pull stomach in. Pull stomach in. Pull stomach in. Pull stomach in. And look straight and up on the ceiling.
That's it. Your gaze on the elbows. Pull stomach in. Pull stomach in. Okay. Put your palms on the floor. Big palms here in front of you. More. Okay. Now bend your knees.
Stay there.
Yeah.
So you need to give a little bit more room in front of the wall. Actually, the head can come up.
Yeah,
the stomach. Pull the stomach. How about you? Push down. Pull the stomach. Go towards the wall. Towards the wall.
Yeah,
backward.
You need to get your middle part of that.
We can do that.
Sorry?
So
and strong. That is really important. You can't just continue to apply pressure, or you can't release it altogether.
Yeah.
You release, but you always be ready to anchor again, to kick in again.
Use your legs and core and lift up as if you're reaching to the ceiling. You're reaching to the ceiling.
And then just hold one leg, check the edge of the bottom. Yeah, just hold one leg and come on the side so that you can come down and kick. Come on, come on. Yeah. Yeah,
are you reaching to the ceiling?
Yeah. Stop.
Reach to the ceiling. Think about reaching to the ceiling. Okay?
So you're doing forward bend, but you can't get the. So let's see how they explain that. If you don't have the length, bend is going to be too sharp and not very good. If you have a longer rope and you bend it, the bend at any given point is not much. But if it's a shorter rope and it has to give the same degree of bend, you have to bend it too much. So when you don't have the length in the spine. When you don't have the length in the spine, and when you try to do the bend, it has to bend a lot at those few vertebrae. Versus if you have the length, every vertebrae is engaged. Now there's much gentler bend at every point in the spine. Okay? Versus this, what is that? The disc pushing out, the needed disc in order. That would happen when some vertebrae have to bend a lot more. Because not every vertebrae is going to bend equally, right? Some vertebrae. So you're trying to bend too much without extending. If I extend fully, if I lengthen fully and then bend, not only my spine is strong, but more vertebrae are probably able to engage and give the bend. Right? That's why this is not a pose, this is a mudra. This is a sort of pre-pose, right? This is just preparing you for the pose. That in forward bend, your spine should be long. And how do you know that spine is long? If you can see the big toe. Right? If you can see the big toe, then your spine is long, and then you do the pose. Dhanushirasana, really powerful pose. So in a Western pose we talked about yesterday, that is a little bit harder because both legs are out, but this is a powerful. So once you're able to see the toe, then bend forward, and your goal is to pull the head forward. So focus on the hip joints. Focus on the hip joints. Pull. Yeah, so take the elbows apart, wide. Spread elbows out. So pull. Shoulders behind chest. Bring torso forward.
But the other chest is the
shoulders.
So now it's just chin.
Okay, sit side. If you haven't told me that. So, Prajna Mudra, there's preparation for the pose by lengthening the spine. And the marker, muscle marker there is being able to see the toe reaching to chest. Once you're able to, then go down and this line, let's engage the bandha. So you exhale and you go on into the pose. Inhale, exhale, then pull stomach in, holding it outside. Release and then inhale. Okay, so once you go on down, exhale, pull stomach in. Release and then inhale. So you practice the bandha in the pose. Stay as long as you can with your head down, on the knee, or chin to chest, and then focus on the breathing. So again, use the belt equally, so your both shoulders are aligned. Keep both shoulders in the same distance. Use belt as much as you can. Don't hold on. Don't hold on back from here.
9:44.
You're able to lay down in lotus, lay down in lotus, otherwise leg straight, we're going to do the upper body lifts, and then we'll do the leg lifts. Right, so the upper body lift, this, first level, well, you can keep your knees bent and foot feet on the wall. If you need some more support for your back, then legs straight away from the wall, then palms in the armpits, and then finally if you're comfortable, palms on the shoulders. Too fast. In general, repetition can cause injury. These things in particular, some of these movements can start to give you cramps. Slower, now just get the big toe on the wall. Start with the palms in the open and then put palms down. I'm going down. That's good. So going down, Mila, put palms on the shoulders. Coming up. Yeah. Shoulders. Across the arms. Right, left, right. Yeah. Try and slow, so not to crash. Yeah, that's good. See what you're doing with the back. Yeah, good.
Okay,
so people put palms out, just try it.
The legs shouldn't lift, right?
I don't very much hold that.
Okay,
watch, come a little forward, your situation. That's good, Sarika, that's good. Okay, any problem? I thought last time it was a bit too far. Much better, yeah. Good to see. See, that is a challenge with yoga, right? You don't see the progress, but how many of you have seen the tree grow? In years, right? You don't see that. Oh yeah, I've grown half an inch more. Take a couple of minutes. And we'll do the leg lifts. So leg lifts, you can do two ways. You can do straight up and down, and then you can do sideways. And those of you who have not done leg lifts before, or so the challenge has to be with your own yardstick, right? It should not be measured with what the person next to you is doing. Does that make sense? It should be what is stretch, what is challenge for you. So please remember that. Otherwise, you will hurt yourself and you will run out from yoga as fast as you can. So it's absolutely okay if you feel that your back is not as strong yet. It needs 2 weeks before it gets there. But you want. It's absolutely okay to round your spine this way and then do the leg lift. Inhale. When you do this, and if your back is not firm, strong, then the back floats. Right? that puts too much strain on the back, right? So what we need to do if you're doing this, you do this pelvic tilt. This, right? So the tailbone lifts up, lower back pushes out, stomach is pushed up. So Adi can stand on my stomach right now, right? Because my stomach wall is pushed up. And then you do the leg lift. You can breathe with this stomach wall pushed up. You see my stomach circumference is not reducing at all. So then my lower back is not floating, it's not moving in and out. That is really important when you do leg lifts, when you do pranayama, I'll show you pranayama. Your body should not be going this way. That's why you get the back aches after pranayama, if your body is not firm. So please, feel free to keep elbows on the floor and then do the leg lift. Or make sure you put some rug or something under your lower back and lower back pushed into the rug really tight so that there is no movement, no gap between lower back and back. We call it really, really powerful pose for again digestive organs, losing weight, strengthening the stomach. Yeah, not push the stomach in. Push into the mat. Ah, there you go. Strong. Make sure the back is firm, strong, pushed into the floor. Keep trying the elbows. Try the elbows. Like a fish.
What's this? Hands like this.
Or at the most, if you can't straighten both ways, bend while lifting, straighten while lowering. Lowering is easy because gravity is helping you. Lifting is harder. So it's okay to bend knees while lifting. And then work on this. Once your back stomach is even strong enough, you'll be able to come straight up as well. Okay, get down, take a few breaths. First long spine, stay straight as you can, and then bend to the hips. Forward, right? Not downward, just forward bend. So you go only once. So stomach, then chest, and then chin. So those of you who have knees up, spread the elbow a little and see if you can nudge. Yeah, gently nudge the knees downward. Yeah, so apply mild pressure with your elbow as well. So sleeping butterfly is a really powerful recovery pose. So this is not very difficult, and you can do this. But if you wanted to do a restorative pose, let's say for 5-7 minutes, you could lay down in this pose. And maybe put a couple of pillows on each side. And that will gently nudge the hips to open. Don't go into a shell. So don't lift the shoulder, something like this. Stick up. Yeah, stick up. Right. And then you put it. So shoulders down. Yeah. Come forward, okay. So don't do the hole in the wall. please come a little bit away from the walls. What is happening to the lower back? Is it talking to you? Is it saying, hey, who are you? And your lower back. Transition to upward. One more starting next, right? The favorite pose. We do half, so we can do the pull. So this is full board, right? So you can hold this, you can hold here. Legs in the torso close to each other. Yeah, straight on the torso, straight on the torso. Come. Legs and arms torso closer to each other. How close can you bring them? And then the half board. The half boat does not float.
Things
right, that's right. Keep palms in the sun. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about your day yesterday. How was your day yesterday? It was drowning.
Sunk.
Good, sorry, good. That's good. So do you really need 45 minutes to get a good workout, right? How much time do you really need? So it's a pose of Kandasana.
Crazy. Yes.
Exactly. I thought that way too. That you know, Iyengar is crazy. That Iyengar's knees are double jointed. You know, we've seen people with shoulders, or that I have heard, that we call those people double jointed, you have shoulders. And but Iyengar's knees were double jointed until I found this. So I can show you the pictures. Arita and Avi took my pictures when I was learning this pose. And I don't think most of you would believe that Pushpak's face can get this distorted. Nothing like this mind. And so I kept cursing my ankles and my knees. I didn't have what it takes to get into that pose. So how am I doing this pose right now with my ankles and my knees?
Lots of practice.
I'm doing it with my back. My back was so weak that my joints were straining. See, the strong member of the family doesn't do what he or she should do. The weaker members have to chip in, and the weaker members are weaker, right? So they don't feel the strength. The joints are the weaker members of the family of bones and muscles and the body. Right? So when the muscles don't engage, when you're not aligned, the joints strain. So if the joint brings you out of the pose, something's not right. Muscles are not doing what they should be doing. Bones are not aligned and not lifting the weight. So my back is completely, fully engaged. It cannot become stronger. It cannot engage anymore. And then I have to lose. It's not the joints. It's the back being really strong. So the joint has a lot of range of movements. Knee does not bend sideways, right? Knee can only bend this way. It does not bend. So see, this movement is coming from the hips. Right? So if my lower back that was not strong enough, that was not allowing the hip joints to rotate, so knee was straining. Because knee was thinking, oh, I'm supposed to bend this way because hip and back are not really. Peacock. Let's do the peacock. Sorry?
I have to leave. I think Padmaja also have to. You have to go to Padmaja.
Oh, okay.
But Nalinyam knows how to back up. So okay. Stay as
thank
long
you.
As you
thank
best you want to. And thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
The back strengthening, and one at a time. So any pose that you do with the ball and supine would be a recovery pose, right? So let's do this. So lay down on your back, and then just hold your one foot. Just hold your one foot, and see if you can see your foot. So see where that movement is going to come from. This movement is going to come from the hip joint. Just appreciate this movement, right? It's coming from the hip joint. As your knee goes away from you, foot goes towards you. Yeah, like that, exactly. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. See, this movement is coming from the hips. Yeah, there's a seat trying to see your foot. Yeah, yeah, yeah. see what will, what movement, what adjustment is necessary in order to see the foot.
Yeah, let me try one at a time. Try one, put one on the chest first. Yeah, put one on the chest and push knee away from you. Remember the knee is located this way.
Come on.
Yeah, exactly. Like that, exactly. Yep. And
don't forget
your the back. Lift your shoulders up a little bit. Yeah, there.
Don't forget your
point.
Yeah.
No, it's stay rounded like this. Yeah. So it's the lower back is pushed up. Yeah, there. So you don't want to cross the middle line. So keep the foot, right foot on the right side.
Yeah, that's nice. There's something genetic. There's a family who comes to yoga, and mother is fine. Her knees are almost to the floor in butterfly. But father and daughter, their knees are like in a 45-degree angle. Break the bell. $100 prize. Nobody has claimed. Please focus on not worrying about lifting the head, but anchor and lower the hips. Firm up. Focus on the back. Let the back talk to you. That's good. And you want to shift forward. So focus on the point. Yeah. Focus on the point and then move that point a little bit forward. Yeah. And then the more forward you go, the lighter the feet will become. Now broaden shoulders, push shoulders back. Broaden the chest. So make sure it's not straining. You do this, breathing becomes difficult, right? Because it's like
head in.
Yeah, this.
But then you are lifted up.
Shoulder's fine. Just look straight out. Right? So this, just look straight out. Your left, your right.
Did
it help? Do you feel the ribs?
Yeah, exactly.
It's one more dimension to push out. So this a little bit apart. Come forward. Lean forward. So your knees are too close to the hands. So take your knees back first. Walk back. Keep walking back. Keep walking back. Yeah, like that. Yeah, that, that's good. It does like, yeah. Then yeah, put knees on the floor. Like, yeah, lower the knees, lower the knees. Yeah, yeah, exactly. See the person. No, yeah. No, back was fine. Don't bring the knees so close. Yeah, there. Okay, now lower the hips and lift your head. That's swan. Keep fingertips in the back, that's peacock. Okay. This, fingertips in the front, and then see just one difference, right? And see how different the poor leg feels if you're not lifting the legs. So knees push down, ribs up.